ChatGPT, Google Bard, or DeepL? Which one translates the best? Coming up. Hello and welcome back to the Freelanceverse. Thanks for coming back to the channel. I hope you enjoyed last week's live Q&A. If you haven't seen it yet, YouTube is always a bit weird with recommending live streams. I'm gonna link the video up here. It was amazing. Almost 70 people joined me and asked questions, and we just hung out, and it was really cool. This week's episode is all about machine translation. 2023 so far is definitely the year of generative AI. The beginning of the year, ChatGPT launched its 3.5 and now recently even the version 4. And it looked like generative AI is going to take off and take over. Since then, it has slowed down a bit, the hype, but it's still here to stay, definitely. Now, this summer, Google was kind of forced to publish something as well, right? Because I don't think this was on the plan for this summer, but due to the waves that OpenAI made with ChatGPT, they were kind of forced to publish their tool as well. So since the summer, in the whole world, Google Bard is live and is another generative AI large language model. Works basically the same as ChatGPT. You input the prompt and you get the generative original content out of it. Something slightly different, not generative AI, but at the forefront of machine translation is the German-based, Cologne, I think, based company DeepL. Many translators use it, I myself included. I have a premium version of DeepL. I use it for certain jobs, certain clients. I think it's a great tool. And today I had the idea to compare what is actually the case, because I feel like many, many people outside of the industry, family, friends, asked me this year what I think about generative AI taking over our jobs, and I was a bit confused and a bit also. I mean, I get what they mean because now it's everywhere in the media. But machine translation, the NMT, neural machine translation, has been around since 2017 and is way more advanced than generative AI in terms of translation, right? So today I wanted to put this to the test, if that's actually true. So I picked a text that I thought would be kind of general enough to be able to be machine translated, but also not too easy. So there are some specific terms in there. I used the text from the Swiss National Museum. It's about their organization, how they are structured in different departments. So there are some specialist terms in there, but it's also a very general text. So it's a nice mix, I feel like, and we can really see the strength and the weaknesses of AI and MT. The good thing is that it's a Swiss company or a Swiss museum, so we actually have the published German text on the website as well, so we can compare with it. Although 100% transparency, I'm not super happy with the translation that is currently live on the museum's website. Maybe I should reach out to them after the video and offer my revising services, because I feel like there is some improvement to be done. But anyways, we're going to use it to compare to see what's actually live and what the outputs provided for us. So let's switch over to the screen view and see what's going on, if we can determine who won this test. Of course, this is in no way or shape or form a test that can be generalized, but I think it's interesting and it's for entertainment purposes. So let's get started. All right, I think you should see me like this. Sorry if it's a bit dark. It's already getting dark outside. Lately, it's been super busy and I'm actually struggling to find time to make videos. So I have to do this in the evenings, in the nights, on the weekends, but I can't complain. It's also nice. Anyway, so you should see my screen now. Up here on the left, I have the ChatGPT version. On the top right, Google Bard. On the bottom left, DeepL. So as you can see, it's quite a short text. I went through it. I marked some things that I don't like, some things that I liked. Okay, and here I have the website. Once the text in German, and here the original in English with the cookies. So now you can see it. All right, so I think I'm just gonna go through it. I know many of you don't understand German, which is fine. I'm gonna kind of talk about the meta here. And give you some feedback on the three versions. I'm not gonna go in too much into detail because it just would take too much time, but let's go through it and I will crown in the end my winner of this exercise. So let's start with ChatGPT. So the title organization, everyone translated as organización, which is very straightforward and makes sense in this case. Also the original website is like that. Then the first sentence is quite an interesting one. That's why I'm gonna go through it in detail here. Under the roof of the collection center, the various collections of the Swiss National Museum, the workshops of our conservators and restorers, our conservation research operations, and the object center are brought together. So it's a very difficult sentence. Under the roof of something, this is united, right? So, and the AIs were definitely struggling with this. This is a typical sentence that you would have to reword quite a lot in German and in different languages as well. All of them started with unter dem Dach des Sammlungszentrums, which is literal, under the roof. You can have that literal. I think also the main website also has it a literal translation. I would probably, if I did this from scratch, I would have gone away from the literal version of Unter dem Dach, but it's a nice collocation that also works in German. Then ChatGPT for some reason went for the dative here for a different case. This should be genitive, this should be des. Bard and DeepL both used des, but ChatGPT used dative. This is a version that is more and more accepted nowadays, dative instead of genitive. Genitive is more the written language, the more correct case, let's say, but it's okay. I'm just surprised that they used dative here from. And then the next sentence, all of them got wrong, right? All of them said the Werkstatt, which is a literal translation of workshop, which is in a way okay. You could have Werkstatt, but Werkstatt is more. But in an art context, like this is for Switzerland, because it is the Swiss Museum, it would always be Atelier. And also in the, as you can see on the main website, they also use Atelier. But that is a small thing that you would have to change in post-editing, of course. Then there are things that the AI can't really know, that these ateliers in the Swiss National Museums have names. So the Atelier der Konservierung, Restaurierung, so that's a proper name. And of course, all of them did this more or less literally, von unseren Konservatoren, so they actually speak of people, Konservatoren und Restauratoren. DeepL did the same. None of them gendered, and everything else on this website is gendered, so they used only the male version, so that's something you would have to change in post as well. Google Bard actually went a different way, which made it worse. I'm not sure why they did that. They gendered Restauratoren, but they completely left out the conservation part. So there is a big omission there that is definitely in the art context needed. And then the next sentence, or the next part of this sentence, says our conservation research operations, which is quite a big compound in English. Not all of them managed it well. Google Bard wrote the Restaurierungsforschungsarbeiten, which is a really clunky big word that you would not really have in one word in German. What did the organization actually say? Konservierungsforschung, which is a bit shortened, but much more common and much nicer. And DeepL went for Konservatorische Forschung, which I find it's probably correct, right? Konservatorische Forschung instead of Konservierungsforschung, but it's just very uncommon and I don't like it. So none of them got this properly right. I would definitely change this in post. The next sentence, I just quickly want to highlight DeepL in that because they did a magnificent job. I actually wrote it in green. The sentence is, the modern infrastructure enables staff to expertly apply their skills and experience in preserving and maintaining our extensive collections. Not an easy text in terms of words, but quite easy in terms of sentence structure. That's why DeepL managed to do this perfectly. Die moderne Infrastruktur ermöglicht es den Mitarbeitenden, nicely gendered, ihre Fähigkeiten und Erfahrungen bei der Erhaltung und Pflege der umfangreichen Sammlungen fachgerecht einzusetzen. It's beautiful, there's nothing to be changed. I would control enter that and just, you know, use exactly like that. So very well done. The same goes with the next sentence. That's actually interesting because DeepL managed to keep the focus on guests, then Gästen. It is the first instance in this sentence, whereas both the other AIs, generative AIs, used a different focus. So guests, which is actually the focus on the sentence, is in the middle. Also here, Besucher, another word for guests, visitors. But the focus is on the seminar room and the desktops, but actually the focus should be on the Besucher. So let's move on to the second paragraph, because that's also very, very interesting there. The first sentence was done perfectly by Google Bard and DeepL. ChatGPT was lacking again there. The Swiss National Museum's collection center commenced operations in 2007. Very simple, actually, right? Only commenced is a bit of a higher register word, but otherwise it started operations in 27. Both of them are very standard, seinen Betrieb aufgenommen, nahm seinen Betrieb auf. ChatGPT, for some reason, das Sammlungszentrum des Schweizerischen Nationalmuseums hat im Jahr 2007 begonnen. Maybe in a spoken context, this would be okay, this would work. On a website of the organization, when they commenced their operations, the register is not high enough, right? So yeah, I was not happy with that option there, but the other two did very well. The next sentence has had two interesting verbs in there in terms of art context. Our collections are managed and maintained. DeepL went for Verwaltung und Pflege, which is management and maintenance, yes, but Pflege you wouldn't really use with art pieces. ChatGPT chose verwaltet und gewartet, which is again managed and maintained, but gewartet is more for like machines, the maintenance of machines. Google Bard actually used a combination of the two, managed and maintained in terms of pflegen, in terms of taking care of something. The actual terms of the museum are Bewirtschaftung, which is a very fancy term of management, basically. So Verwaltung is also fine there. Then Sammlungserhaltung, which is kind of a synonym for conservation, and that is very frequently used in the art context. So none of them got that right. Why the human touch is so important, right? It's just proving that, in my opinion. And actually with this text, you would probably have quite a lot of work to do post-editing. I'm not sure if it would still be faster, probably, but you would get a much nicer text if you started from scratch with something that is almost a specialist text, with specialist text anyways, in my opinion, but this one even also. So the next sentence is interesting because I don't like at all the translation that is on the website. Über die Fachbereichs- und Häusergrenzen der Museumsgruppe hinweg. I don't like that. The actual sentence is a new style of collaboration transcending the boundaries of the separate departments and the various establishments of the museum group has been ushered in. Very difficult sentence. Also, the museum itself didn't really get it right. I don't know exactly what I would do, but I think I would rewrite it, the whole thing. And that's not something that AI or NMT does, right? So that's, of course, the output of this is going to be quite literal and you would have to reword that quite a lot. Let me see which one I like the most. I really didn't like ChatGPT, ein neuer Stil der Zusammenarbeit, der über die Grenzen der getrennten Abteilungen und verschiedenen Einrichtungen hinausgeht. Wurde eingeführt as well, like ushered in is not what they eingeführt, like it just happened through the previous operations, right? So all of them said what they eingeführt, which I don't really like. What did the website say? Hat begonnen. So it's much more neutral. What they eingeführt is someone is launching it, someone is initializing it, but it just started, it just began through the previous operations. I think I like Google Bard most in this sentence, but even there it's like the Grenzen and die einzelnen Abteilungen, verschiedene Einrichtungen, Grenzen überschreitet in this context. None of them are good, I would rewrite it completely. Interesting case example, definitely. As you can see at the end, there is not much going on in terms of color, only in DeepL. In the generative AI versions, ChatGPT and Google Bard, they were just okay. There were nothing to say, oh, that's yellow or that's green. You know, they were just, you know, scraping by. Whereas DeepL, I was actually really impressed by the next sentence. Bringing the different departments together under one roof has enabled us to completely reorganize the workflows and process within the collection center and the National Museum. A new level of professionalism has been achieved. A very difficult sentence, and at least the first part of it DeepL'd it very well. Durch die Zusammenführung der verschiedenen Abteilungen unter einem Dach konnten die Arbeitsabläufe und Prozesse innerhalb des Sammlungszentrums und des Nationalmuseums völlig neu organisiert und ein neues Maß an Professionalität erreicht werden. The second part is not bad. I would rewrite that a little bit, but I was very impressed to see that DeepL managed to decode this like boxed in sentence, because the other two versions didn't really manage to do that. For example, ChatGPT just put a comma there and then just added the second sentence, und ein neues Level an Professionalität wurde erreicht. Yeah, that doesn't work, right? That doesn't look natural, that looks very translated. You would have to change that. And then a last negative example of DeepL, actually. It's also a really tough sentence when you look at the architectural, technical and operational infrastructure that was envisaged, planned and implemented is at the center of this new era of museum cooperation. There are three steps within a couple of words, and DeepL made the decision, the bad decision, to put them even closer together. As you can see there, all the three steps are within, literally next to each other. Die konzipierte, geplante und umgesetzte architektonische, technische und betriebliche Infrastruktur. So that doesn't work, right? You need to break that down a bit. How did the other two do it? Die architektonische, technische und operative Infrastruktur, die geplant und umgesetzt wurde, ist im Zentrum. Okay, not bad. Für diese neue Ära der Museumszusammenarbeit gedacht, geplant und umgesetzt wurde. Gedacht doesn't work in ChatGPT, so Google Bard did the last sentence the best. Overall, my highlight is definitely DeepL. They did by far the best. I would still need to reword this actually a lot, and also the actual website translation would need to be reworded. I think a combination of the website and the DeepL plus my input would be optimal. Second place was Google Bard. I was actually quite impressed with a few sentences that did quite well. You have to also keep in mind that these generative language AI models, they are not made for translation, whereas DeepL is specifically made for translation. So it makes perfect sense that DeepL won this challenge. I was quite disappointed with ChatGPT, I have to say. There is one sentence that I could say it did the best, but everything else, it was definitely lacking behind DeepL and also lacking behind Google Bard. So I was quite surprised with that, because ChatGPT is, you know, at everyone's forefront, and that's what we think is the industry standard now. But I have to say, in terms of translation, DeepL number one, Google Bard number two, ChatGPT lost. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Very different type of video. As I said, take this with a grain of salt. This is just a case study, a very small text. Of course, with the language models, you could prompt it, reword it. You could say, can you write it a bit more in different style? Can you rewrite it to this, which you can't do in DeepL. So that's a limitation there. But how these two will be combined to something in the future will be very interesting to see and to follow. I'll see you next Monday with the next video. Bye bye.